This is Keith from offlix.com. About a month ago, maybe a little longer, I released a video on how to install OpenStreetMaps on your new Garmin Edge 520. A lot of people were complaining that the audio quality, it sounded like I was whispering, which I totally agree. So this is gonna be kind of a re-edit of the audio portion to fix that, hopefully, and to correct a few issues with my original explanation. So I hope that works. Okay, so here we go. The first thing you're going to want to do is go to the website listed in the description, garmin.openstreetmap.nl. You're going to select generic or routable, and then you're going to want to select your predefined country. That's very easy. Just select it from the drop box. You know what? Click enable manual tile selection. That'll enable you to limit the file size, because if you can see on the far right, the selected tiles on this one are currently 229 megabytes. You want to keep that under 50. Hopefully 45 to 50, that should be good. So you deselect all the tiles around your area. And as you deselect tiles, you'll see that your file size, final output file size, will be lower. So that's a good thing. Zoom in the map if you need to, and just deselect until you get to around that range of about 45 to 50 megabytes. Once you do that, you enter your email address and click on Build My Maps. After that, it's gonna take you to a little confirmation screen. And it'll basically tell you to wait, that you'll to be expecting an email. And once you get that email, you have to wait about 15 to 20 minutes. So give it some time, don't get worried. When the email comes, it'll look something like this. It'll have a link towards the bottom. You click that link and it'll bring up all the files available. For this purpose of putting the OpenStreetMaps on the Garmin Edge 520, look for the one with the little micro SD icon and download that into your browser. It'll download into your download folder. Might be different for Windows or Mac. This is the setup for Mac, but it's something very similar. Save that file on your desktop and connect your Garmin Edge 520 via USB port to your computer. In this case, you can see in the Mac, it'll show up as a little drive. You could probably right click on Explorer and see it somewhere as one of the connected drives if you're on Windows. So you click into it, and you're browsing the files on the actual Garmin Edge 520. You're gonna look for a map that says gmapbmap.img. If you're on a Windows computer, it might just say gmapbmap without the file extension img. To play it safe, create a folder on your desktop, drag the gmapbmap image and also the gmapbmap.sum into that folder. Once you move those files into the folder for safekeepings, you can go ahead and right-click and delete the original file. On both Mac and Windows, to play it safe, I just go into the trash folder and delete those there too. Once you do that, you're going to open up the zip file that you downloaded from the website earlier, extract that somewhere, maybe on your desktop to make it easier, and it's gonna have a file that's gonna get extracted. It's called gmaps.upp.img. If you're on a Windows computer, it might just say gmaps.upp. In that case, you don't have to add the .img if you don't see it there currently. But for this case in the Mac, you're going to change the file, rename it to gmapbmap. Bmap, that stands for basemap.img. The img is already there, so you don't have to add that. On the Windows side, if it doesn't say img, you don't have to add that. Drag that file that you just renamed into your Garmin device folder. Wait for the file to upload. It might take a while to actually upload to your actual Garmin, to the Garmin Edge 520. Just make sure you have your backup files in place. You'll see the status. I'm sure it works pretty similar to the way it does on the Mac on the Windows side. So it might take a minute or so to actually complete. You're gonna want to safely eject the Garmin Edge 520 from your computer, and you're going to want to restart it, and that should load up the maps. On your next boot, it should be available with the new OpenStreetMaps. So hopefully that does it. If you have any problems, you could read in the description. I'm going to list some of the common problems that people have had when performing this task. For the most part, it's very simple. But if you do run into any problems, it's always simple to correct them. So you can't really mess it up too much, but I have to add the disclaimer of do this at your own risk, because these are not official files and something can go wrong. It's not very likely, but stuff can go wrong. So that's about it.